The Apple Vision Pro. You've probably already seen the unboxing, the reviews, and the features. The thing is, there's so much new tech crammed into this device, it's the first of the first. And well, the inside of this is a complete mystery. I don't like mysteries. That's why in this video, we're gonna tear this $3,500 Apple Vision Pro down. We're gonna see how this thing is constructed, if it's repairable, and in the next video, we're gonna be swapping parts to see if Apple pulled an Apple and, well, serialized any of the parts. I have no clue how to open this, and honestly, I'm kind of scared. But Apple did leave some clues in some of their videos and keynotes. Based on this, I would assume it opens from this end, which is where we'll start. Before we do anything, we're gonna remove this, and we'll pop off the head strap, just like that. And now we have the Apple Vision Pro in its rawest form. This thing is beautiful. First things first, we're gonna grab our heat gun and we're gently going to heat up the front of the glass, making sure we're not heating up any areas for too long. I hope this is where you open it from. Now that I think of it, it's probably a good idea to actually cover the lenses because unlike other YouTubers, I am not rich and I really don't want to break this. There we go. Now we have the OLED displays protected. That's probably the most expensive part of this whole thing. We'll continue to heat this up. That should be good for now. Now we'll take our plastic prying cards. All this stuff can be found on my website. I post the links to everything I use, so go check that out. And if you want to do this yourself, not necessarily with this device, you definitely can. I'm taking the corner of the plastic prying card and trying to get under the glass to see where that takes me. But plastic didn't get me far at all. I had to quickly switch and started using the Jimmy tool, which also didn't get me too far until I pulled out this tool. It's specifically made for curved displays, and well, it was slicing straight through that adhesive. There was two layers that I was slicing through though. One of them was the top layer, which had a plastic vinyl and it was kind of peeling up. I figured the second layer was probably a better layer to pry up on, and thank God I did. After applying consecutive heat and prying, it finally popped off. Holy crap. That was a very difficult process, but it looks like we have the first ever look inside the Apple Vision Pro. This thing is as intricate as I would have thought. In the middle, we have the LiDAR sensor. Over here and here, we have the true depth cameras. This is actually a dot projector, very similar to what we have in an iPhone for Face ID. Over here, we have our main two cameras, and we also have the IR illuminators here on the sides of both. And then on the actual front with the display, we have another side camera. So it looks like we have a few flex cables here, obviously for the two side cameras and one for the actual display. And they all connect under this bracket here, which I assume is one assembly. Much like the Quest, it's just so much technology jam-packed under this massive shield. And I don't know if we can get to the shield without removing a bunch of stuff. So that's exactly what we're gonna do. We'll start off by unfolding whatever this cable is. Seems to be an antenna cable of sorts. We'll do the same with the other side here. Now it is still tethered via this antenna. It does look like this is gonna be a very, very tricky disassembly. We're gonna go ahead and hit the Apple Vision Pro with an unscrew, pretty much just eyeballing it. I don't know which screw to take out yet. Of course, we have a hidden screw. We'll go ahead and unscrew that. So what I'm noticing is both sides are pretty much the same, which is very interesting. Now we can disconnect the flex cable. We'll do the same thing on the other side and disconnect the second side camera. And now we can lift this up and go ahead and disconnect the display. This is the front of your Apple Vision Pro, fully removed and working. So I went ahead and placed some stickers over the sensors so that they don't get damaged or dust doesn't get into them. Why? Well, knowing Apple, these are probably serialized. That's something we're gonna find out in the next video. But for now, I'd rather not damage them until we can do that. I do, however, want to remove these arms because they're making the process of removing things really annoying. So if I'm correct, there is this little hole here, and I'm thinking it works a little bit like a sim ejector hole where you just stick a sharp and thin object. And what the hell is that? They added a lightning port looking thing. Interesting touch. It is cool that these are removable though. I don't think the Quest even has removable speakers, so good looking out, Apple. We'll put these aside and let's continue diving into this device. Because there are no tutorials or any instructions on how to do this, it's kind of like a little puzzle. Remove that and remove that. With every piece we remove though, we get closer to finding out everything about this device. We'll continue to disconnect everything. All of these connectors over here seem to be connected to the sensor array, so everything I disconnect probably corresponds to that. This is the LiDAR sensor, and this seems to be the dot projector. Unscrew. This is probably your Bluetooth antenna. We can actually go ahead and disconnect these antennas. And it looks like I did rip a flex cable. There are some antenna flex cables running up here. So when you're prying, this probably isn't the best place to start. Nor is this, but this one seems okay. I don't think I ripped that one. We'll see what effects this has later. These are probably the actual display cables. They look a lot like MacBook display cables, so I'm gonna assume that's what they are. We'll go ahead and disconnect them. We'll disconnect the other side's display cables. We have more cables over here. This is probably for the fans. Before we go any further, we have the R1 chip under here and the M2 chip under here. I think I can actually peel this off and get a closer look at them, so let's try to do that. What? What is that? Perhaps the R1 chip is below and not above, because I don't see any R1 chip here. We'll do the same to the other side. And there's no M2 chip here. So it's probably on the other side, which gives me more incentive to get there. Let's go ahead and unscrew the rest of these screws and get this thing fully apart. Unfortunately, it wasn't that simple. We ran into a screw we've never seen before. This is a hex nut, but it also houses another screw within. Not having the tools to remove this nut, well, we had to get a little bit creative. By creative, I mean converting this nut into a flathead screw. Crisis averted. But the next crisis, unfortunately, did not end so cleanly. Apple seems to have completely booby-trapped the camera and sensor array because we removed literally every screw, but there still was no removing this thing. The only thing left to do really was to go in from the other side, and well, let's just say we did not make a clean entry. Not clean at all. Yeah, it turns out there was an easier way to do this. The fabric was glued to this frame and would have actually come out as one piece if we pried it. There's a few more screws to get through, and now we're able to pull up on the displays. There's two connectors attached to each display, and now they can just slide off this rig. And finally, we found the screws holding in the camera and sensor assembly. Oh, thank God.
Why did you do it like this, Apple?
And take a look at this. This is the board of the first gen Apple Vision Pro. Never seen a Bendy board before, so this is definitely a first, especially from Apple.
Now that we have the board removed, we can pretty much remove everything else. That includes the stepper motors, which adjusts the displays based on your eyes. They literally move back and forth. We can also remove the fans, which kind of look like mini turbos. I really hope this still works after we put it all back together.
Hello.
And there it is, the Apple Vision Pro torn down. Was this easy? No, absolutely not. With this device, there's probably no tearing it down without damaging it even to the smallest degree, which honestly sucks. The front persona display and cameras are easily removable, and they're probably going to be the most commonly broken part of this device. If you break anything else though, you're pretty much screwed even by AppleCare. The battery being external means if you take good care of this guy, well, you can probably use it for a really long time. The only thing harder than taking this apart, putting it back together. No, seriously. This took a really long time, but it'll all be worth it if this still works. Let's see if it does. Don't mind the tape. And this is actually working. We fully tore this down and we fully built it back up. The Wi-Fi is working, so the ripped antenna didn't really affect anything. But our next video might affect a lot of things. Be sure to check that out when that's available.